a close battle in the C division, and we are going to head over there to pick up our game with the Money Shots up against the Zombies. Welcome to the RCHL. Dana Wilson here. Well, it's been a while since we've looked at the Zombies, and when we last left them, they were in the middle of a rebuild phase. Even though that they've got a lot of new names in the roster, things really hasn't gone any better, as they had been shut out 3 times at the beginning of the season. Last week, they finally scored some goals, but still came up short against the Mighty Viking Devils. So they're still looking for their first win, but at least this is a step forward for them. For the Money Shots, they're currently in a battle for second place. They've held the number one spot, but have fell in the standings since their win over the Labatt Blues. Now, ever since what happened in that particular game, there were reported 2 players that were suspended from that incident. Now, Autumn Cowart, who left the bench, was given the minimum 2-game suspension as per rule 38 of the RSHL rulebook. So she's expected to come back today, but we'll see if she does. But how are they going to fare with each other? We'll go to the breakdown, and we will start with the Zombies. But like I said, there's going to be a lot of new names that you're not going to recognize in this roster. We're bringing in Alan Black, Ben Kingry, who we're going to be watching today, who scored the first 2 goals for the Zombies. Evan Ray, Greg Smith, Joe Velu, Carter Grew, Steve Gerslin. There's going to be a lot of names that you don't know here. And it's going to be a complete mystery as to what they're going to bring. But what we do know is right now they lack a good offensive core. For the Money Shots, we've already looked at this back last time, so this time we're going to be watching BJ Goodwin. 3 goals, 1 assist in his games. He is one of the few that has a little bit of experience in his play with the likes of Zach Smith and Chris Valley, who each are tied with 6 points in the standings. Now, they've been in a slump for the past couple of games, so we'll see if they can turn it around. But for now, we are coming up on the ball drop, and it is next.
Started a little early for us. We're running a little behind, so only missed 30 seconds, but you have not missed anything yet. Turnover. The Zombies trying to get some going. Shot from Smith goes wide. Back to Smith one more time. Shot, save, and collapses. Won by Money Shots. Dumped around the boards. We get taken out by the Zombie. Trying to clear it out. Overstretched it, but it does clear the zone. As the Money Shots tag up, and the Zombies will get their first offensive rush for today. Bike up off a body. That's Carpenter. Tries to beat up it around, but Carpenter tying him up a little bit. Pika has to go back. And then around they go, 2 minutes gone in the first period. Carpenter centers up and got tied up. Second chance goes wide. Money Shots putting on a lot of chances. Back it goes to the Money Shots. Can't get a shot off. They attempt another clear. Still can't get it out. Second chance they finally do, and they have to chase this one down. Zombies get a full line change. And see, Money Shots get a full change of their own. Valley trying to look for Riggy, but instead goes into the corner. And a little tied up. Centers. Chance for Riggy. She got tied up. Valley with a poke check. Jinx around one. He's going to try to turn himself. Center score! Money shot. Set it up. Outside post. And it is 1-0 money shots. I know Valley's going to get the primary assist, and the other is going to go to Ken Meshack. Won by a zombie. Hello, trying to push it up, getting tied up with DJ Goodwin. He gets possession, trying to find an opening. He'll have to take it himself. Centers. Trying to find Sikorsky, but it will be the zombies. Back the other way. Poke check. A couple of times. Centers intercepted by Smith. He gets double teamed, but escapes. Looking at two more defensemen. He takes a shot and covered. Toss up for control. It's going to be pushed out. Autumn Cowart, who's just coming back from suspension, pushes it back out. Tom Pollock trying to push out. Intercepted by Smith. Centers. Good with a shot. Goes a little wide of the net. Centers. Turnover chance. Saved. Sikorsky set up in the center. But a point blank chance doesn't work. Pollock, all the veterans for zombies. You see that the zombies bench not happy with how they're playing, trying to rearrange and a poke check. They have not got a shot on net so far. Pollock trying to push it up towards left side. That is intercepted once again. As they will get a line change. In the meantime, zombies just trying to get anything going. Pushes around to the left corner. They switch places, drops, and intercepted by the zombies. Centers, off a foot, trying to regain control, does. There's a shot, save! And that is our first shot at the game for the zombies. Evan! And it will belong to the zombies this time. Drops the bike up. Attempts a shot, blocked, intercepted, and a partial break the other way. John Wolf to the left corner. Has Carpenter as an option. Tries to go for him. Didn't quite connect. Back to Wolf. Wolf hearing a call. Decides to go to the opposite point. Wrist shot tipped along the way. Goes down and cleared away. And off the stanchion, it stays in play. That was a lucky bounce, but it goes to the ceiling and a faceoff. It goes, shot going to the glove. That wrist shot coming from Cam Neshat. Back around. Zombies trying to get something going. Trying to rearrange. Back it goes to Mark Bica, and he'll clear down the floor. No ice here. As the money shots clear into their own bench and a face-off in their zone.
Evan, We don't want to turn it over right there. I'm standing there, you're standing there, and they were behind us. Good job.
And that is won by Money Shots. They will clear out of the zone. And Bica trying to look for an opening and intercepted by Neshat. Tries the centering pass and intercepted. Back the other way for a Zombies. Gets around Colbert. They head to the corner. And kicked away. And it will be poked behind the net. Bica centers and can't get a clean shot. Goes wide. And a turnaround shot from Bica that is blocked. He gets triple teamed, and here come the money shots the other way. And instead, they'll just dump it, and they will get a line change.
Go, go, go!
And they just clear it out, and this will end up being an icing against the Zombie. One by Goodwin, quick shot is blocked from Smith. They're just trying to clear out of a dangerous area. They do clear out. Gets around Colbert, and I don't think he's going to have the speed to race this one down. Can't even get an easy clear attempt as Goodwin crosses the line, but they're offside. One by the Zombies, and he'll try to push it down the floor. Gave it away. It does get past everybody as we approach the 4-minute mark. BJ Goodwin for the money shots. We'll chase it down to the left corner. The Zombie is trying to direct defensive traffic. And now a very crowded corner. Goes back to the point. Tries the wrist shot, trying to look for a tip. Intercepted by Villo. And push back down again. Forecheck that's on top of the Zombies. And this is pretty much how the season's been going for the Zombies this year. As he will push down the floor. And dangerous area as he'll have to clear around as they're in the middle of a change. Attempted centering pass. Drives a wrist shot, looking for a tip. Turnaround shot, save! Still loose ball. Back to the point to Villo. Still in the zone. Centers up. Shot, save! And the Zombies starting to get some offense going. And tries a shot, goes wide.
Point!
Trying to find an opening, gave it away to Carpenter. Stretch pass, back to Gift. Pollock. And off the official, Kevin Frost. And I saw that it got him between the legs. Right, he easily shakes that off. I don't think that even fazed him. And poor pass, and a shot going way high.
Just
rode the stick all the way up. Bica backhands it, blocked, tries again. Still can't reach him, triple team with three green jerseys. Back to Bica. Low roller, blocked. Colbert for money shots will take it along the boards. And now getting crowded, they do get through. Franklin gets tied up. Bica back the other way as they tag up. Drop pass. From the left point. Try to stretch it back to Mark Bica. Goes right by him. Switches places. We'll have to go behind the net. Darce Carpenter again for money shots. As we approach 1:30 left in the first period. Bica again. Centers. No one available. Attempt to clear, goes through, but it's an ice, I think. Yes, it is. One by the zombies. Quick shot, save!
Good job, Ben.
Well, he's faced several shots. Steve Colombo holding his own. Less than a minute remaining in the period. 2-on-1 for the money shots. Valley to the next shot, save by Todd Bascom. And we got time for another face off with 30 seconds left. One by the money shots. Shot, another save by Bascom. One by the money shots, one more time. Shot going wide from Neshat. 5 seconds left, see if they can get time for one more shot. Tries, I don't think they're gonna get it here. And that will do it for the first period. So a lot of the control going to the money shots. There have been some bursts of light from the zombies, but they are behind, 1-0 after one. Back underway this time. Wicked Thing started on time as Goodwin attempts to clear, does get through. Race down. It goes around the boards trying to find a white jersey, instead finds Zach Smith. But he still can't get to it. Zombies have it. Marshall 2-on-1. Tries to dig around. Backhand blocked. Attempts to clear off a foot. They battle for it. Going down. No call from what I can see. As everybody just poking around under there somewhere. As they come back one more time. 2-on-2. Getting blocked. And back down the floor it goes. As Bascom drops it off. And nearly turned it over. He does turn it over. Shot saved by Bascom. Bails him out this time. Another attempt to clear. Shot goes wide. Starting to get a little sloppy on the defensive end. And another attempted shot is blocked. Smith tries again, that's blocked, and Bascom has to die for it. Wow, that was a messy sequence for the zombies. One by the money shots, backhand, just goes a little wide. Pollock trying to get something started for the zombie. He's triple teamed. They are all over them. And now to tie up along the boards, trying to push it out. He does. Mark Bica will have to race it down along with Ben Stone. Tries to look for a pass, intercepted by Carpenter. Carpenter on a 2-on-2. Tries to center, blocked. Tries again, to an open man, shot! Where is it? And that is a save by Bascom. A lot of point blank chances for the money shots. So many open men in the slot. Another attempted pass goes by everybody, but the zombies will have control. Attempt to clear, Bica does get through, as Galoppo will just cover. One by money shots. attempt to clear off a body. Velo tries a shot, blocked. And here comes Valley the other way, trying to get a break. On pursuit is Tom Pollock. He'll push him to the corner. Tries the center, off his stick, and here they come back the other way. 3-on-2. Attempt a starting pass off the stick of Stone. And, well, he could have got called for the high stick, but they let it go. And tries another pass to Neshad, goes right by him. Backtracks, tries a shot, and Riggy tries one, but whiffs it. And centering pass off the stick of Bascom. Attempt to clear between Stone. Stone gets it down. Zombies trying to get anything going. Well, Biker definitely has the speed over Haswell. And he's going to try to look for a chance. Wraps around, blocked by Haswell. And Riggy, oh, did Riggy take something up high? Because I saw her head jerk back, but no call. I didn't see what happened, but it looked like she took something up there. In the meantime, the zombie's trying to get anything going, but he's stripped of the ball. Was that off? They say no. Money shots disagree. Riggy attempts to clear. Again, she can't get it. Was that one high? And it's covered up by Galapo. There was another stick that looked like it was going to go high. But, again, no call. Tie up. Money shots with control. Waiting for an opening. Attempts to clear, but it's down the floor for an ice. One by Money Shots. Off a body, goes down in the slot. Everybody dig in. Back to the left corner. Attempting centering pass, off a stick. Money Shots with control. On the boards, and a little too far to handle, but it is Sikorsky. Sikorsky looking for some help. He's getting tied up. He's gotta watch the hands. His hands around him, they're gonna let him go for now. And they deeks around 2-on-1 for the zombies. Looks for a shot. He takes it. Save by Galapo. Backhand, another save. A third chance. Digging in somewhere. It pops out. Gift with a shot. Save. Still loose. Tries another one. That goes wide. Attempted clear. Trying to push through. He does. Sikorsky. Well, he'll leave by some time. Goodwin. Right. Get their attack started, but it's pushed back one more time to Galapo.
Center.
Galapo up to Autumn Collart. Poke check. Was that offside? They say it is offside. The zombie don't realize it yet. In the meantime, they do attack. Well, they're in the process of changing up. They do tag up. In the middle of that change, wrist shot off the stick of Galapo. Another chance, blocker save. Centers and can't get a shot off. That was Steve Gersland who was setting up. Smith, attempted clear, still in play. Tries to jump back in, no one available for the zombies. They all try to push back out. Here the money shots. Trying to make some arrangements. They'll just dump in as Bascom will drop it off the gift. And I can see quite a bit of green jerseys by the circle that are not covered, and that shot goes wide. Yeah, this has been a big problem for the zombies. They just can't get anything started. They turn it over one more time. Tries to center up. No one available. Attempt to clear again, tied up by Carpenter. If they do, push it out. 2-on-1 for the zombie. On the right circle, centers, backhand, in the air, he scores! Took some hard work, but the zombies finally break through, and they get the game all tied up. That just took a strange bounce right over Garoppolo's head, and that was the bounce that the zombies needed. So the goal has been credited to Steve Gerstlin. And off the boards. Now the zombies have something to work with. And nearly had a bounce go against them as Riggy was right on top. Here's Fika. Fika looking for an opening, tries to center off a body a little wide of Galoppo. Fika. Looking ahead, two green jerseys, centers up off a foot, goes back to the point. A little miscommunication at the point, and they are forced to push it into the right corner. As they attempt to loft it up to Riggy. Kept in, zombies still have control. Wrist shot going wide of the net. They wanted a high stick, they're not getting it. It's about three high sticks that were not called. And another chance, open chance, just rolls wide of the net. And now they try again. Another shot go way wide and a good bounce. He scores! Galoppo thought he had it in his pants and it pokes through. It's a good goal for the Zombies. 2-1. It's their... Well, it would have been their first lead of the season 1 for last week, but they got a lead now. So everything's starting to fall into place for the zombies. They had their first lead of the season as well as their first goal of the season last week. Only four games into the season. But now they got a good lead against one of the better teams of the league. And they're going to rush in this time. Goes around Colbert. Holds up. Tries to Rashad going a little wide. Didn't miss by much. Tries to clear up one more time. Good win. Backhands it up to Sikorsky. Getting pestered by Tom Pollock. Trying to backhand it up. Can't get it off. Pollock gets it. Gets a poke check from Goodwin. Along the left end boards. Goodwin holds up. Trying to shake off Pollock. Tries a center pass, intercepted. Pollock one more time. He'll attempt to clear. Kept in at the line. That was Castles.
Great. High slot. High slot.
Intercepted again. Shot saved by Bascom. Still a loose ball. Then they clear. He'll just push across the line, and Cowart is forced to push it back. They now tag up. Good poke check, and here they come again. Goodwin. Shot saved by Bascom. Pollock again one more time. Gets in by Castle. Shot wide of the net. And we got a whistle. And a too many men call against Money Shots. And yeah, look at that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's one too many. And John Wolf will be serving the penalty.
Well, we can't have sweat. I want to go first.
One by the Money Shots as they will have to kill off our first penalty of the game. Shot on the backhand save by Galoppo. Gift, wrist shot, score! Deflected in, but I think this should go to Gift. there's no way that Galavo could have reacted that quickly on such a quick-changing shot. I think our gift, rather, is going to get the goal here. 3-1 Zombie. And stolen away by Carpenter. Being chased by Bailo, backhand, and blocked by Bascom. Carpenter, center, score! Good feed from Carpenter, and the Mighty Shots are back within one. And it is Kyler Franklin with a backhand one-timer. Straight out of play, we do it again with 30 seconds left. Now the Zombies had a 3-goal lead in last week's game. It had drained away. They're going to try to change things up this time around, but they're getting a little tied up. Attempted clear, nearly turned it over. Getting poked. Everybody just piling on. They clear, and it will be an icing, but I don't think we're going to have enough time. Are they going to let it go? No, they're not. But we're not going to have any more time for another face-off, so that'll do it for this period. So the Zombies fight back and are now on the good side. They're going to have to hold it this time around. 3-2 after two. Ready for the third period. Now the Zombies had the lead last week, but they're going to have to change it to ensure that they hold on to it this time. A little toss up on the face-off, won by the Money Shots. And poked away, they head to the boards, getting tied up with Sikorsky, and here they come. Deeks around one, poke check from Smith. Trying to retain it, and we'll go to the wall. Poked by his Ben Stone, and here is Zach Smith off a leg. And that ruins the play for Zach Smith, played off the scorekeeper's table. Off the loose stick of Autumn Cowart. She was trying to chase it back down. As they will dump it one more time. The Money Shots have been in a slump for the past couple of games. They do have both people back from serving their time on the discipline list. And tries to set her up. That was a bit of a dangerous pass. Kept in by Cowart. Off a foot. Pokes it back. And turns it over. Trying to race this down. Here they come. And taken down. Saved by Gillen. But we may have a penalty coming up. Are we going to have a 2 minutes or is it going to be a penalty shot? The question is, did he have a breakaway? Did he have a scoring chance taken away? So we got to determine if this is going to be 2 minutes or a penalty shot. It's going to be 2 minutes. But if I were the Zombie, if I were the Money Shots, I would rather take the 2 minutes over the penalty shot. But Cowart taking it in good stride as she's going to sit out for 2 minutes. One by Money Shots. Attempted center and misses everyone. Gift. Wrist shot off a body, backhands it. Kept in by Gift. Another shot. Score! Second of the game for Adam Gift. The wrist shot from the point and a power play goal. Misguided, came down with snow on it. Back to Haswell, attempted clear, is blocked. Taken down, penalty coming up against the Money Shots, another one.
Here we go.
And it will be a tripping call. Another power play for the Zombie. And it is going to be Ben Haswell.
Keep it going, boy.
One to buy money shots. They're gonna have to do everything they can. Down by two. Interesting that Galoppo decided to go down on his knees with the ball nowhere near him. That's interesting. I wonder if something has happened to Steve Galoppo. He was down his knees the whole time. Now he's getting back up. I don't know if he's just exhausted or what. Shot off the stick of Galoppo. Pollock backhand blocked. Out it goes. As the Zombies will make one change. Circles around. Attempted pass up to Pollock. Does. Make sure everybody's on the same page so you get through. Pollock with a shot. Saved by Galoppo. Left corner. Tries to go back to Pollock. He'll try a shot. Tipped on and a save by Galoppo. And they will clear and kill more time. Fastcom. We'll have to drop this one off. We have 50 seconds left on the power play.
We're back.
Goes left to Pollock. They tag up.
Go. Get it.
Pollock. Cross it. Tries a shot. Didn't get all of it. It just trickles a little wide of Galoppo. Back around it goes.
Coming your way.
Looking for Castles.
Middle.
Castles clears. And gloved down by Bascom. And trying to make a decision. And he's going to cover.
Okay.
20 seconds left on the power play. The Zombies have had three, and they converted their first two, but they may have their first penalty killed. One by Money Shots. 5 seconds left on the penalty. Shot and a save by Bascom, and they get their man back on the floor.
Or in this, yeah, the Tazwell. I forgot it was him instead of Coward.
Back around it goes. To the right corner, attempt to clear, does find Valley. Valley gets cut off. 9:20 remaining in regulation. The Zombies have not had a win in a long time. Shot and a save by Bascom. And here's another shot. Backhanded, open chance, score! Chris Valley brings the money shots back within one. One by the Zombies. Now they have to deal with a one goal lead. Hopefully it is not deja vu for them. Shot just going a little high. Centering pass intercepted. Smith the other way, 2-on-2. Being joined by John Wolf. Drop pass. He'll leave it for BJ Goodwin. He'll take a shot that is blocked. Glove down. Trying to keep possession as Gift clears it. Autumn Coward. We'll just push it back down the floor. And it is Gift. He'll just push it back up to Bica. Centers didn't get all of it. Sikorsky and an offside against Money Shots. One up by the Zombies. They'll have to chase this back. And down the floor, and it's going to be an icing against the Zombies. The last time that the Zombies won a game was back on September 23rd when they had faced the Money Shots in the slot. Turn around. Can't find an opening. And kept in, trying to keep the play alive for Money Shots.
Like I said, the clear fails. Carpenter tries to drive it back in, gets double team. Bailo on pursuit. Back to Gift. Attempt to clear. Goes through as Cowart mishandled it. And a poke check to the right corner. Taken down and no call. I believe a stick is loose. Everybody just fighting for the lives back there. Backhands it, back behind the net, and around it goes. Michael Oliver for Gift. Has two for the game, back to Bica. Tries a shot, stick save, still loose ball, and covered up by Galoppo. So like I said, the last time the Zombies won a game was back on September 23rd. And since that game, they have scored a total of, there was 9 goals last season, they had 3 in the previous game last week, so that would be 12, and then 4 today, so they got 4 goals today, when in the past game, since September, they had scored 12. Wrist shot off the glove of Bascom. Left corner. Trying to shake it off is Velo. He'll play it around for Gift. Back in his own corner, taking a poke check. And nearly in a dangerous spot. And they will get back to safety. Across the line, money shots pushed back. Leaves it for Velo. Velo off the boards. Neshad for the money shot. Tries to push back off a foot. Gets it back himself. He'll dump it. Velo along with Neshad. Velo tries to look for a Gift. Does. Back to Velo. Velo waiting off the boards. Trying to find some help. Does. Off the shin pad. Poke check. Tries to dodge around one. Out of his reach.
Dump it. Matt, dump it.
And they will just decide to push it back across to Gift. Waiting. And now tries to play off the body in the slot. And there's a shoe loose on the floor. Trying to see who that belongs to. And I think that belongs to Castles. I think that's Castles' shoe that's loose on the floor. Now he's going to try to go for a call. Shot from Wolf and a save by Bascom. 3:50 remaining.
Get out, guys, jump it.
Everything's got to go deep. Everything's got to go deep.
And they're calling for a timeout. Well, I heard some from Zombies call for it, but the money shots called there first, so they should be the ones charged with the timeouts. So yeah, money shots called their timeout first, so they will be charged with it. 3:33 remaining in regulation. They're at least keeping it close. But we'll see if the curse hits on the Zombies again. As mentioned before, they've only scored 12 goals since September. They have 4 today. So the goals are coming from Adam Gift. He's got 2 for today. The other goals are coming from Mark Bica and Steve Gerslin. Toss up, back to money shots, poke check. There's a shot off a body, attempt to clear, fails. Pollock with another attempt off the boards, still can't get it out. Pollock.
Try to push it on BJ Goodwin. As we approach the 3 minute mark, we will be in a stop clock soon. Trying to push it through, just barely stays out. And Bascom did not even attempt to go down on his knees. Back to Valley, thinking about it, now goes back to the boards. Tries a backhand, saved by Bascom, he covers. We have 2:50, well the clock should be stopped now. Yeah, there it is, 2:49. Won by the Zombies. And attempt to clear, blocked by Valley. He'll take a shot, blocked, but it goes wide. Shredder scores! Now the question is, did this go to Valley or Goodwin? Either way, the money shots have tied up the game. They're gonna give it to Goodwin. So it got tipped somewhere, but the money shots have tied us up with 2:41 remaining. And we already had an overtime game today. Are we going to have a second? Push back behind the net. Sikorsky looks for the backhand. Open chance! Still loose ball! And it comes out. Bruce Gerslin. Pushing it back across the line, they tag up, taken down. And I think they were gonna call it offside. Are they gonna call a penalty? Yep, it is a penalty for tripping. And it is gonna be Gerslin.
I know.
So now the main focus of the Zombie is just get your guy back. It's not a bad thing. You can push it to overtime. One by Money Shots. Smith here in a call. Decides to center off a foot hot. To Castles. Castles waiting, now attempts a shot going wide. Penalty coming up, and this is gonna be Price sticking. Loops ball, delayed call, and another penalty against the Zombie for high sticking. Things have just gotten worse. So 5-on-3 for a minute 43.
2 minutes, high stick.
And tie up on the draw. Right now, they're focused. Just get it over to overtime and a save by Bascom. But the clock stops at 1:56. This will be a tough challenge for the Zombie. But it will be really rewarding if they kill off these penalties, and that is a good start for them. 1:45 remaining in regulation, 1:23 remaining on the first penalty. Valley takes a look. If they can at least push it overtime, that will be really rewarding for them in the standings. Chance! Score! Power play goal, and the money shots have stolen the lead away. So we just go back to our standard power play, but the money shots now have a big advantage. Just about got nearly the whole rest of the period, so the Zombies are going to have to score shorthanded. They'll have to push it around the boards. Stolen. Yeah, they're going to have to shoot shorthanded, and a save
Bascom is still in the net. They may want to consider trying to pull him. As we approach a minute remaining.
Get off! Get off! Wolf get off!
Left.
Get
blocked.
Get offside!
There it was a offside. Right now they just need to keep going for now. Is Gift. They're gonna have to attack. Off a foot. Fika trying to get something going. Out of his reach. Valley centers.
Watch your back door.
Goes to an open guy. It is Sikorsky, and he whiffs it. Tries to go around. He scores! Chris Valley again. And it looks like the money shots are gonna come back to win this game. And a penalty has just been called on Bascom, unsportsmanlike conduct. And I know that he is frustrated, especially the situation that the Zombies have been having for the past couple of games. But right now, there's just nothing that Bascom can do. So Bascom has been called for unsportsmanlike conduct, and the money shots are going to come away with a victory, 6-4. Glove down. Yeah, I understand that Bascom could be frustrated with how the games have been going the past few weeks, and we got a whistle, and it's a hold call. And is this going to be Zombies again? Oh no, they're going to call it against Money Shots. So they'll put the 4-on-4, but that's not going to matter. And it's Haswell again. And I think the Zombies have just called their timeout. And Bascom is about to blow a gasket. He is angry, and he just tossed his helmet on the bench. Yeah, he is angry. Yeah, again, I understand that he is frustrated, but but 15 seconds, gotta get two goals. It is a far cry. But they're going to at least attempt it. They're going to put Bascom on the bench and go for an extra attacker. It's a long shot, but they're going to try. One by Money Shot. And they are just going to try to kill down the rest of the clock. They attempt to clear, turned it over. Loose in the slot, it is off the goalie, and that will do it for this game. The Money Shots come back to win 6-4, and it has hit the Zombies again. A team comes back to win the game, but you got to give credit for the effort on the Zombies. In the past two games, they have scored 7 goals. That is a big improvement over the past few months for them. So the best thing they could do is just work on top of that one step at a time. But the Money Shots will get second place alone with the draw between the Blues and Mighty Viking Devils. We'll be back with a wrap up.
Well, the frustration continues for the Zombies as once again they have the lead, but it drains in the end. But there is some good news for the Zombies. They are starting to score. So now they have to start working on their back end to try to get things all figured out, and hopefully they can start climbing the standings. Again, they have now scored a total of 7 goals in the past 2 games, which is the most since September. So that's pretty good for them. As for the money shots, with this win, that'll give them second place alone after that draw between the Blues and MVD. So it's a very tight race as far as who's going to at least get second place. But we still got another half of the season to go. So we'll have to wait and see where everything goes. So that will do it for this game. We'll have more for you next week. This is Danny Wilson. We'll see you next time around. If you enjoyed this game, be sure to check out the other games here on our YouTube channel at Raleigh Street Hockey. Also, be sure to check out our sponsors at allblackhockeysticks.com. You can get an all-black stick for just under $100. Not a bad deal. Also, be sure to check out our other sponsor, Hagen Hockey, which has some great hockey equipment for you. In order to get free shipping, just use the promo code RaleighStreetHockey.